It has been 6 months since we lost our friend and leader, Tom Draper, and many of us still feel that loss very deeply. But as time goes on, we realize the many ways he is still with us.
Right. The recent acquisition of MTS Broadcasting in Cambridge made many of us realize that Tom's legacy reached further than we ever knew. Charlie explains how in this special edition of Travels with Charlie.
People love local radio.
I've grown up with the station. Yeah, and I still love it. I listen to it every morning.
To talk about.
And Maryland's mid-shore counties have four local stations to love.
History. I'm ready. Let's do it. Hot new country all-time favorites, 100.9% pure country.
106.3 The Heat. WCEM Radio 1240.
Down Marvin's Oldies Authority 107.1. The Doug, there's Gladys Knight of the Pips. Gotta use.
These are tough times for radio, but each of these stations has its own loyal following.
The thing that I think is keeping radio alive is those announcers. They talk about what's going on in their community.
106.3 is always on in my car radio. It's actually number one on my button set.
By an interesting coincidence, in 1949, this station was purchased by Peninsula Broadcasting as the company that owned WBOC at the time. Just shy of 70 years later, the company that owns WBOC now bought it back again.
We've been looking to expand the company, and it turns out that we approached the owner of MTS Broadcasting, and the time was right for him and for us to reach a deal. So we're back in the radio business now with five radio stations, in addition to four television stations.
Now, things have changed a lot since 1980, when a court-ordered breakup of the Baltimore Sun's media holdings on the shore gave Tom Draper a chance to round up local investors and purchase WBOC-TV. Today,
huge companies buy massive amounts of television and or radio properties, and they program them all the same with no regard whatsoever for the local community. That's where I think the problem comes in.
Thank you so much for being a part of my morning and your morning together here.
A radio station is a bunch of machines that make sound travel infinitely faster and farther than it can go on its own. But it's really about the people on both sides of the dial.
My first job in this business was at WTHD in Milford, Delaware.
Now that happens to be the radio station that Tom Draper started in 1967. Over the years, that young man's business plan would grow into a business philosophy.
He had a desire that I wish a lot of owners that I have worked with in the past had. And that was a desire to give the community an ear, a voice. I mean, he loved the community.
That's why WBOC was so successful. Look, Tom Draper, his picture is right up there. And I think about him every day when I open my door. The first thing I see is Tom's picture. And his words echo in my mind. We have a moral obligation to serve the people of Delmarva. I mean, think about that. If we live up to that every day, Charlie, whether it's television, radio, or our digital properties, I think we'll be okay, as long as we remember that we're here to serve the people who count on us.
In Cambridge, Vienna, Church Hill, and points in between, this is Charles Paparella for WBOC News.
Well said. And on behalf of all of us here at WBOC, we welcome our new co-workers from Dorchester County. We'll be right back.